Okay, Thomas, we're going to review some reports. You've been doing a real good job on your comments, on your reports, and I appreciate you always contacting me when you got questions about something. So that's awesome. So anyways, I'm going to show you how to review your own reports and how to upload them from ISN and HomeGauge. So we'll do a few of them together, and then you're going to start doing your own. You've been doing a great job. I'm real proud of you too, man. Let me just breeze through here, and looks good. Looks good here. Nice cover photo. Yep. That should be a large. Yep. Very good. If you got two cover photos, then medium. So, okay. So we got foundation. Yeah, all your comments are usually pretty good and pretty thorough. So we've been doing good there. Good on your grammar too, and your, all that good stuff. What's going on there? Looks like some damage. That looks like almost like carpenter ant damage or woodpecker damage. Let me take a look at that. I don't know if you said anything about that or not. Let's go. Report, show photo log. Let me just breeze through here real quick. Yeah, boy, that looks like woodpecker damage, possible carpenter ants. I've seen both of them look that way, so yeah, yep, yep. Nice bat, yeah. Hanging light fixture, live wire, this wire here is frayed right here, yep, it's pretty worn. Yeah, like the carpenter damage. Did you see any carpenter ants stuff inside? What's that? Oh, Redex, let's get rid of the mice. Okay. Okay, I'm back. Yeah, so this damage That wasn't in, that's in poor condition. I don't know what you're talking about. Was in poor condition. Well, I'm just going to say. North side. Head. Damage. North side head damage. 32B from carpenter ants and or woodpeckers. Is woodpeckers one word? I think so. Woodpeckers. I'm just gonna copy this, throw this over here, add all these comments together. And then I'll just and we're gonna go over here and just say deciding it is on the house. And damage. It's a lot of damage to that siding. Vegetation, we always want to answer this. I don't care what it is, we always got to answer it because Nachi says we're supposed to. So, grounds are snow covered, so that's good enough. Or the one below it is just as good. Right here, grounds are snow covered around the home, and therefore the bottom areas and walls were not inspected. So, that's one you could use. So, either way. In the summertime, you can, there's other comments in the summertime, but you want to go in here, highlight this, go to your edit, uncheck it, and then hit OK, and then it's always going to be ready. Right now, you got a red X on it. Okay, so here's a comment on my cheat sheet that you should use, comma, right here, add this comment to it. I take it there was a septic here, but we didn't do it, so. Does your drain tile go into this? Didn't see no drain tile. I wonder what they're doing here. Strange. Okay, so I thought I seen some wires here that didn't look all that hot. This wire right here. Right here. Let me just mention that. If I can even drop that in there. Okay, now this is a safety concern. These non-vented space heaters are terrible for carbon monoxide. So, especially in a bedroom. I mean, if it's out in a breezeway or in a garage, that's one thing. But when it's in a bedroom, that's not good. So I got this comment right here. It's in your comments right here. Functioning CO detector. I'll put a comment in. Investigate. Okay, and then right here, furnace. I don't see an overall picture of this furnace, but it looks like it's an older one. Where's that furnace at? I'd like to see an overall picture of the furnace if possible, Thomas. I don't know if it's visible anywhere in any of these other pictures. No, I don't see it there. Okay. Oh, well. I want an overall picture of the furnace. We're going to use a standalone comment here. This first one here, right here. You want to make that standalone, okay? You can click this, okay? Highlight it, hit the toolbar, and then automatically click that one, and then it's going to automatically pop on there. Okay, it's going to be kind of like this electrical one here that automatically pops up here. Okay, same with your furnace. So you have to do that to your software. Yeah, I don't know. These are a safety issue, Thomas, so make sure you mark that with this comment. I always put it INV. Those things are so sensitive to set off carbon monoxide. They don't burn right, there's no vent. You doubled up on your comment there, so let me get rid of that one. Answered. Okay, good job. Make sure it's home inspections. Okay, good. Let me just look at this heating comment one more time. Okay, so this is an older furnace, so this comment is not really good for an older furnace because it doesn't have a draft fan. Most likely it doesn't, but it does have a flue, a draft inducing fan. Yeah, so that's why I want to see this thing. Well, anyways, a fan and a flue and fan is a draft inducing fan. The little thing in the, when you take off the compartment cover, you'll see that fan there. On these older furnaces, it's not there. So you got to make sure you edit that comment to fit the furnace, okay? This uploaded, so I'm gonna show you how to upload because you're gonna start doing your own pretty soon here, buddy. So we're gonna make sure it's at home inspection cover page right here. And it always remains the same. It goes back to the last one you use, home inspection. So if you gotta do a septic and or well, then you would go down here to septic, inspect septic, septic and well, roof, you know. So let's go back to home. Okay, there it is, hit open. Okay, let me breeze through here real quick. Good. Now we're going to upload. Make sure all your pictures are the right size, all that. Double check your summary page. Okay. Always double check your summary page. And then you hit upload. Hit yes. And we're going to go to Thomas. Right there you are. And we're going to go to viewing, make public. We're going to click on this thing here, copy.
Hello.
And hit yes. Now we're going to go back to ISN and we're going to take that link we just copied, and we're going to go back to ISN, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to paste this in here, missing the cover photo, and payment, so, strange. So let's go to action, upload report. Hit this, provide a report URL, click there. We're gonna put home inspection in there, and then we're going to paste, hit enter, make sure this is checked, and then hit set report URL. So did this guy pay or not pay? What's this same point?
I just want to make sure it was not just NA.
Okay. Not sure if this was paid or not. He was present. I think he should have paid. So now I gotta stop, let me double check, always double check, make sure it's there, the right report is there. Yep. Okay, so now I gotta text you and see if, okay, you put the check number in, good. So, all right, so we gotta upload that report. I think I already uploaded the report, so I had to pause you for a second. So the report is uploaded, okay, but now I wanna put the attachment in for the. So what we got to do is we got to go over here, invoice, and then you're gonna go, it's paid with the check number, so we're gonna download it, and then we're gonna add it as an attachment into ISN. So it's circling right here, you see it? Okay, and it's gonna drop down here. Okay, now we can go close. And then we're gonna go to invoice, we're gonna go to, upload in attachments. And we're gonna go to select folder, we're gonna go to downloads, and we're gonna go to invoice. I think this is it right here, 2198, let me see. Yep, 2198, hit open, hit the green button right there, and it's gonna throw the invoice in there as an attachment, make sure it's public. So make sure this thing is checked right here. See that check mark right here? Right there, make sure that's checked so it turns green. Alrighty, now we're gonna go back to view inspections here. The other thing we gotta do is we gotta get the cover photo in here, right here, for the house. So we're gonna go to, the report number is 25120, so we gotta click here. We're gonna click this thing here, then select photo. So we're gonna go find that, home gauge, report 25120. Where is it at here? 25120, right here, click, and then there's the cover photo, hit open. And it's gonna pop it right down in there, and it's gonna bring you back. Everything should be done. We should have the cover photo in there, and all of this here, so good. So now we can go to email report, send it out to the client and to the agent, and then I'll send it to you once, you know, you don't need to do that, but let's see, so we gotta go attachments, public attachments, and then send report. Great. All right, and now that it's sent, we can send it out from ISN, and since it's paid, you see here's the photo now, since it's paid, we can send it out from HomeGauge. Okay, so let's go to HomeGauge. Here you are. All right, and then here we go. So this is HomeGauge. Here's now, if it's not paid in ISN, then you do not send it out from HomeGauge. Capiche? Okay, but since it's paid, we can go ahead and send emails. Click there, and then we can click all of these, and then we're gonna send emails. All right, so we send them both ISN and HomeGauge. Good job.